Last time on punctuation. After losing the treasure, Professor Wirt calls his cousin, Inspector Brackett, to investigate. Later, the treasure is found at Pop's Soda Shop, and you won't believe who stole it. Professor Biochem. And now, episode 11 of Punctuation.
Whoa. I can see why you and Inspector Brackett really like this place.
Yep, it's pretty cool.
Hello, gentlemen. Good to see you.
Yeah. Where's Biochem?
Well, he's been taken down to headquarters for questioning. But, as you can see, here is the treasure.
Still can't believe he would do something like this. I mean, I've known him for years. Why would he do such a thing?
Well, what can I say? Some people may look nice on the outside. They can be evil on the inside.
Well, there is some truth to that statement.
What can I say? He did have problems with English grammar, so I'm assuming that he had problems with punctuation, so he needed the symbols to help him out.
This stinks. Well, there's not much we could do over here. Come on, Professor. Let's head back to the studio.
Okay,
take care, Inspector.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
Hi everyone, welcome to Shaun Allen Films, the educational series. I am Shaun Allen, and for some reason, my intro for this video got deleted. Whoops! Anyways, this is episode 11 of Punctuation. In our last episode, we talked about semicolons and colons.
If you haven't seen the previous episode yet, click the annotation above. Or, if you can't see it, click the link down below entitled, Previous Episode. In today's episode, we're going to be looking at the rest of the punctuation marks.
So if you're ready, then let's get started. All right, now let's go over what we're going to be talking about in today's episode. We'll be looking at quotation marks, the dash, the ellipses, percent sign, at sign, and sign, and many more. Yikes, that's a lot to look at. So let's start off with quotation marks.
Quotation marks are pretty easy to remember. You would use a quotation mark if you're writing a quote down or quoting something verbally. Here's an example.
Ouch! Stop pinching me, Terry, said Ladybug.
See how the quote is separated with the quotation marks? This is known as a direct quote. Here's another example.
I'm sick, said Lawrence.
Is it because you are green?
Asked Terry. Get the idea? You can also use quotations with questions and exclamatory sentences.
Now, if you were to use a quote inside of a quote, then you use only one quotation mark for the quote that's inside the quote. Now, at the very end of the quote, you use three quotation marks. Okay, that sounds confusing, I know, but here's an example of what I'm talking about.
Terry said, I wanted to play marbles today. Be sure to invite Lawrence,
said Ladybug.
That's me,
said Lawrence. Did you see the example? That's what you should do.
Quotation marks can also be used to separate words in a sentence. Basically, they stand out more. Pretty simple, right? Now remember to use quotation marks wisely. They can be tricky at times. So be sure to read your textbooks, listen to your professors or instructors, and hopefully you'll be able to understand them a lot better.
All right, let's move on now to the dash. It looks like this. If you were to use it in an essay, you would use two hyphens. Oh, by the way, I'm actually referring to when you're actually typing it into an essay on your computer or laptop. However, if you were writing down the dash in an essay, you don't need to use two hyphens. That's only for the computer, like I said. It's basically a line on the sheet of paper.
Dashes are used to shift dramatic tones or restraints in sentences. Plus, they are used to set aside appositives that contain commas. Also, they can show emphasis in a sentence that needs it. Check your textbooks for more information about this.
Now, here's a funny word for you. Ellipses. What does it look like? Well, here it is. An ellipses is basically three periods in a row. What does it represent? Well, it could either be in place of a deleted word or words from a quoted quotation. That way, the quote isn't super long. Also, it can be used to show boredom. See what I mean?
Try to remember not to use an ellipses at the beginning or ending of a quotation. Because if you don't have a beginning, well, your quotation's gonna fall apart. And if you don't have an ending, well, you're gonna leave your readers hanging for a cliffhanger. Ellipses can also represent unfinished